Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. We now begin business session two. Before that, a big round of applause for Mr. Manoj from Zeal. Thank you, Manoj, for that very lively session. We begin business session two. Entrepreneurship enablers. The chairman of the session, I now invite Mr. Raju Venkatraman, Managing Director, Medal Healthcare Private Limited. Very warm welcome to you, sir. I invite the distinguished speakers for this session, Mr. S. Mr. S. Venkatesh, Managing Director and CEO, Goli Vada Pav Private Limited. And Mr. Murugavel Janakiraman, Founder, CEO, Bharat Matrimony. Mr. Raju Venkatraman is a serial entrepreneur and managing director and CEO of Medal Healthcare Private Limited. Medal has over 60 centers in all the states in South India, serves over 2 million customers and employs over 1,700 people, including 100 MD radiologists and pathologists. Mr. Raju is a member of the Young Presidents Organization and founding member of World Presidents Organization in Chennai. Mr. Raju is a charter member of TAI and a recipient of Entrepreneur Award from TAICON from Tamil Nadu government in 2008 and 2009. I now hand over the session to Mr. Raju. So before you take over the session, announcement, question and answer session will be after the presentations by the distinguished speakers. The mic will be provided to the audience, so you could pose your questions after the presentations are over. Thank you.
Good afternoon. I know it's very difficult after lunch. Ellarkum tamil theriyuma? Thank you. First of all, my sincere thanks to all of you for coming out and trying to spend some time with all of us and trying to understand a little bit about entrepreneurship. Ipo iniki na vande nariya pesanona vandirken neenga la quiet a irninga na pesalam. How many of you want to become entrepreneurs? Wow. Now I'm going to tell you my admiration for entrepreneurs. I am myself a serial entrepreneur. I became an entrepreneur probably for the first time when I was 14 years old. And ever since, I went back to study in IIT, worked for a company called Cadbury's, and then went to America to work for a company called EDS, and then became a full-fledged entrepreneur in 1991, and at that time I was 32 years old. Can you hear me okay? Okay. This light ivlo perusa irukkuma illa korakkalama onnume. Good. Entrepreneurship is not everybody's cup of tea. Entrepreneurship has got lot of meaning. Now, first in 1991 la America la entrepreneur anambodhu, my wife's friend asked me, Raju, ipo neenga lunch daily veetla vandu saapidreengla? Are you coming home for lunch every day now? And I told her, I don't have lunch. If I get to eat lunch, it's a lucky day. So entrepreneurship means lot of hard work. So those of you who raised your hands, I'm 100% sure that you will be very successful, because the environment in India now to become an entrepreneur is really very good today. The opportunities, if I were to put, I have done business in 18 to 19 countries and I've traveled to about 38 or 39 countries. After living in America for 20 years, I came back to India because I believe passionately that India is the future. So all of you, you are in the right place. You are absolutely in the right place. If you want to be an entrepreneur, India is the place to be. I'll tell a brief story. My first business was in IT services. I built a product which I quickly converted to what we call as business process outsourcing, so that I can get continuous revenue. And I'm going to give you a few case studies in this session. The whole idea is to talk about enablers of entrepreneurship, the ecosystem that is there today. What does it take to be a successful entrepreneur? The definition of entrepreneurship is, if you want to be a successful entrepreneur, you must find a need. You must find a need in the society. You must find something that is missing. You don't have to necessarily invent anything. You don't have to build a product. Today you will hear about Goli Vada Pav story. You will hear about Bharat Matrimony today from my distinguished speakers who are going to be with us today. These are all great stories. And I really hope that at least half of you who raised your hands will become great entrepreneurs. Now, is a farmer an entrepreneur? Great, good answer, correct answer. Is a paanwala who sells and he owns that store, small store, I eat lot of paans, is he an entrepreneur? India has 75 million entrepreneurs. Outside the temple you will see the flower lady there. She buys bulk flowers. Pua kotam oru madathukku 10 rupayaku 20 rupayaku data paathu vippanga. They are great entrepreneurs. And if you want to really learn entrepreneurship, and if you are coming from a middle class family where it is tough to meet both ends meet, you can learn a lot from your mother, because she knows how to manage the resources, the limited resources that is there to keep the house going. One of the most important job of an entrepreneur is to manage the resources. You will never have infinite amount of money. In fact, most of the entrepreneurship actually starts off with a very good idea, and they go out and make that idea work and generate cash. So I'll come back to the first case study that I wanted to talk to you about. Is a very young entrepreneur I met when he was 25 years old. He had just gotten out of college, and this is in 1990 or 92 that I met him. He had started a cable TV laying. You know, in those days cable TV had just started. And he told me he had 100,000 customers. So I asked him, do you have any competition? And he said, no, all my customers are fine, except when the kids go to the 10th standard, they cut off the cable, they don't give it to the kids, so that I have to make sure I know the customer, which family is not going to have cable TV. Then I asked him, how come you maintain the loyalty? He said, it's very simple, sir. I don't sell cable TV to them. I know every one of my customers through my people. I know that there is a man there and he goes on tour and his wife is very nervous and we tell her anytime she wants she can call and we will get her the medicine to take care of her kids if they are sick. And he also went on to say, older people, we took care of them, sir. Small things we did for them, like getting milk in the morning, making sure that. So we filled a gap that was there and these customers were loyal and they paid us on time. We never had to worry about collecting the money. Now that is an entrepreneur. He was selling cable TV, but he was actually getting his customers locked in because he added other value-added services to them. So whenever you are in business, whenever you become an entrepreneur, it is extremely important for you to run that extra mile for your customer. It is not the product that you sell alone that will differentiate you. It will be something else. So you need to tune in to those needs of your customers. The second story that I'm going to talk about is the number of hats that one has to wear as an entrepreneur. You know, at one end, when I started Vetri Systems in 1991 in America, I had a total of $10,000 in my hand. And I had a mortgage of $1,400 a month. And I had a fantastic job. I quit that job because I passionately believed that I can be successful in bringing out products in digital imaging in those days. But I tell you, the journey was tough. I used to consult in those days. I was very successful in my job. I worked for EDS and I had sold over $100 million of systems for EDS. So I thought I can easily do for $3 or $5 million for myself. That's how the business plan came in. And from the day I started, I had a lawsuit from EDS saying I cannot take any one of their customers. So I knew American healthcare at that time. I knew the mortgage industry, but I couldn't sell there. So I went and sold the idea to a publishing company called LexisNexis. And there I saw an opportunity. At that time, Satellite was launched. InSat-1 was launched at that time and we found out that you could transmit data. And it was not easy. We convinced LexisNexis, which is today called Reed Elsevier, it's a $9 billion company, to ship their work to India. And we processed their data in India with our software. We didn't sell our software. And that company grew to about 3,500 people in 4 years' time in Chennai. But the challenge is where to find the people. In Chennai in 1992, we ran in shifts, 6 a.m. to 2 p.m., 2 p.m. to 10 p.m. Nobody would come to work at 6 o'clock. That was the biggest challenge. But guess what? After 2 months, everyone had perfect attendance in our company. So the skill that I had to sell software, to make software, was of no use. The greatest strength that I needed was to convince these 600 people to come to work at 6 a.m. in the morning. And another 600 people to come at 2 and go at 10. And in those days, if women stayed late, their parents would come to our office because they never liked their daughter to work late. So we had a room for parents. So we had to cater to the needs and very slowly the older parents would say, we wish we were younger, we want to work for a company like this. So if you become an entrepreneur, one of your job is to make it interesting. I think the previous speaker spoke about having a lot of fun at work, but a good entrepreneur continuously thinks ahead of time and sees what will be the next problem that he is going to get. So an entrepreneur's job is extremely difficult. Then once you become a bit successful, you want to expand. We wanted to put 3,000 seats. We didn't have capital. Remember, we started the business with $10,000. So you have to build relationship with the banks. You have to communicate openly and honestly. I didn't take any money from investors, but we were lucky because some of our customers liked our work. They gave us advances. These are all the skills that you need if you're working with B2B businesses. I'm also going to tell you some fun stories. Whenever you become an entrepreneur, you will have a lot of fun, I'll guarantee you that. I was invited by the largest bank in Finland, and I went to Finland, and the managing director's office was half the size of this auditorium. He had a big conference table, he had a big office, and there was another private section there. Then his name was Auntie Verta. I used to call him Mr. Verta. And he said, Mr. Venkatraman, you and I are going to go do a deal. He wanted to buy our software. So he said, please come in. Then I said, what about my translator and my sales guy? He said, no, the two of us will go do the deal. So we went inside. And the next thing I realized is it's an open spa. And very quickly he said, here is a towel, feel free. And he was naked in less than a minute and he went into the water. And he said, in Finland, this is the way we do big deals. So I had to remove everything, very shy. What all we do for a deal? It was a $1 million software deal. It was the biggest deal at that time. So I went in there and then he goes, from now on, I call you Raju and you call me Auntie. I said, Auntie, okay. And every culture, you know, I did deals in Italy. I did deals in places that you wouldn't believe. I had businesses in Trinidad. Trinidad, if you get to go, it's a fun place. Grenada, Barbados, China. And I'll tell you another story in China. Suddenly in 1999, I had 1,400 people working in China. I get a fax from an employee asking for my permission because she wanted to get married. The employer had to give a consent in China, which I didn't know. It's fascinating that if you get involved, the amount of cultural things that you will learn as an entrepreneur. You have to keep yourself constantly updated. See, whatever you do, I did chemical engineering and I'll be very honest with you. How many of you are engineers? And how many of you want to be engineers after you graduate? Good. I used to be like you. Because I knew that if I had practiced chemical engineering, there would have been another Bhopal. I was a lousy chemical engineer. I knew that, but I finished it, right? So finish your engineering and then open yourself up to the real world. But if you want to be a great entrepreneur, while you're in college, you must do a few things. You must sell something to somebody, which is a value. It can be a small tournament that you conduct. And you raise money to the tune of 1 lakh or 2 lakh. Or you must do a social or a cultural event and you raise money, not just spend money. And if you can do that and convince the sponsors and give them value so that they don't feel cheated, you would have learned a lot to become a great entrepreneur. So don't miss out on these opportunities. whatever be it, whether it is placement cell, whether it is in the cultural, literary, sports, you know, hostel events, take part in those. That will help you a lot, because a good entrepreneur is a great person to be with. People, ultimately, if you're going to be successful, you need people to work for you. If you want people to work for you, they must know that you are very fair, you're fun, you're going to help them, you're going to teach them. And those are all the other things that we say are very important. Now I have another about 11 to 12 minutes left. I do want to touch upon the ecosystem a little bit. How many of you are bored? Not, no? It's okay. See, today, everybody wants to become an entrepreneur. How many of you plan to get married in the next 10 years or 5 years? Please raise your hand. Thank you, thank you, thank you. All of you, right? Most of you. Great. Are you going to go to a course to become a good husband or a good wife? I really believe that you have the instinct to be a husband, you have the instinct to be a caregiver to your wife or a wife to a husband. Nobody teaches these things. Similarly, entrepreneurship, I don't think you will have to learn in a school. It will come to you naturally if you keep doing right things. But there are quite a few things. Is the AC working? People are sweating in the back a little bit. I know after lunch it's very boring. You're meeting your friends after a long time. If you give me another 7 to 8 minutes, I can cover what I want to. Then there are two other speakers. I want to tell you this, that today, if you join an organization called TAI, it's a great organization. Madras Management Association is a great management association. In the days that we grew up in, we didn't know the word entrepreneurship. So don't worry too much. You know, people ask me, Raju, how did you go about becoming an entrepreneur? I'm telling you, the real reason why I am successful is I'm really dumb. I cannot see the risks. If I see the risk, if I calculate, the more MBA I do, more analysis I do, I will paralyze myself, I will not take any action. Similarly, if you start analyzing which girl you want to marry, if you're a guy, put a spreadsheet and put points for that and learn all that, how to evaluate, you will never get married. So be bold, be bold. The first thing is to get an idea. There was a guy who came after a session like this and said, sir, can you give me a couple of ideas for me? I want to become an entrepreneur. Ideas have to be yours. You must understand the need in the society. There are so many success stories. I'll tell you one, a latest one. A bunch of IIT guys created a product on iPad. Fabulous product. It's confidential, so I won't go beyond that. It's a fabulous product. I saw it. And they got an order. They got an order from 75 stores. And they wanted to sell the software on iPad for 30,000 rupees or 3,000 rupees per annum guaranteed for some number like 3 years. The math didn't add up, but they wanted to sell it outright for 30,000. And the guy who wanted to buy had 50 stores, and he said, see, I don't want to buy software. Can you sell the iPad with it? These guys said, no. We are not a hardware company. But the guy said, I don't want it. They came to me. I said, why don't you go and ask them how much is he willing to pay? They said, they are willing to pay 2,000 rupees per month for the iPad and the software. So if you do the math, 3 years, it is 72,000. With discounted cash flow, it is still 60,000 rupees. We got a guy who sells iPad on per month and took 2,000 and sold the deal. So sometimes what you want to sell and the way you package it is completely different. So don't say no to your customer. Understand the economics. Understand his point of view. And I really believe that this company will be 200 to 300 crores in the next 2 to 3 years. We hear a lot of horror stories. All of you are business graduates, is what I have been told. Can anyone define business quickly in 3 words? What is business? Keeping man busy. That is business. Okay. Anyway, in the paucity of time, I will say it. 3 simple words that if you remember, I have communicated how you can become a successful entrepreneur. Sell, deliver, collect. You must know how to sell, and you must deliver what you sell, and you must collect the money. You know, 95% of entrepreneurs go bankrupt because they don't know how to collect money from their customers. So learn that skill. Sell, deliver, collect. Sell, deliver, collect. That's all the mantra is for an entrepreneur. Because ultimately, cash is king. Now, for you to grow, you need a lot of cash. You will have angel investors. You will have friends, fools, and family willing to come and help you when you are successful. Then you will have banks. You will have to build relationship with banks. Then slowly you will have to get relationship with maybe venture capitalists, private equity players. You may have to take a company public. These are all good problems to have. And guaranteed, I didn't know any of this. I have sold 3 companies successfully. I have taken a company public. And I have bought over 90 companies so far. You don't learn all this. You will learn it on the way. Don't worry about it. So don't start preparing for the 15th year of marriage and what if my wife doesn't like me after 15 years. Don't worry about it. Get married. Have fun. Right? Same thing with entrepreneurship. The other thing that I wanted to talk to you guys about was, you know, legally, you know, there are several ways to form an entrepreneurship. Partnership, in my opinion, you have to be extraordinarily careful. If your business is going to be extremely successful, I mentor a lot of entrepreneurs. At least 60 out of 70 entrepreneurs that I know who have successfully built a company, the partners have a fight with themselves. It is a static partnership. Initially, each of them put 10 lakhs. Each of them are equal partners. Suddenly, the company has become 20 crores. One guy says, this is good enough. Life is good. The other guy says, I want to grow it. The other guy says, I want to cash out and go to the beach. And they fight amongst themselves and destroy the value. So be careful on how you build the partnership formulas. Don't make it easy. If you really believe in your business plan and don't be afraid to take a lot of risks, you will get paid for your effort, but you will get rewarded for your risks. There is no entrepreneurship without risk. If you don't take risk, you're not going to get rewarded. So all these big dreams that you have of having a 5-story building in Mount Road, owning your own office, living in boat club, being a member of all the big clubs out here, Madras Club and so on. All this will happen. But you have to be shrewd, you have to be smart to protect yourself, and you have to continuously create value for your shareholders, which could be you included. Sometimes you will have people. If you take money, there are four things that I say that kills entrepreneurs. Got another 3 minutes. First one is fear. If you have fear, you are over. No, Bharatiyar said, Achamillai, Achamillai, Acham Enbadillaye, Uchimidu Vaanidindu Vizhugindra Bodhilum, Achamillai, Achamillai, Acham Enbadillaye. So you need to conquer that fear. See, you cannot avoid fear. You have to conquer that fear. That's what Nelson Mandela said. You have to conquer the fear. Nobody can escape fear, but you have to conquer it. Second quality is laziness. Again, Bharatiyar beautifully said, Odi vilayadu papa, oindirikka lagadu papa. Don't be lazy, don't be sitting there. Just go out and do it. Keep trying. A successful entrepreneur is a guy who has failed many times, but he has never failed to get up after every failure. That is the definition of a successful entrepreneur. So fear, laziness, ego. When you become somewhat successful, you don't listen to others. And it happens to me, and my wife is the best judge. She will tell me, Raju, ego kore, listen to people, you will be successful. So you need somebody as an advisor with you to give you some good positive thinking. And the fourth thing that makes entrepreneurs fail miserably is greed. Greed is you agreed with your investor that he is going to get X percentage. And suddenly you feel, hey, he's making a lot of money. I have to pay off. He is getting 92% return. I should give him only 41% return. Then the entrepreneurs start destroying the value in the company. Now, these are good problems to have. These are, you know, 90% of the time, I have been an entrepreneur who started with nothing. When I had nothing, I had no problems. When I had millions of dollars in the bank, I had lots of problems. Problems will come only when you have money in the bank. So be careful not to expose yourself too much. So if you can conquer these four, fear, laziness, ego, greed, and if you can go out there and find a need in the society, it can be small things. You will hear two great stories today from my fellow speakers. I really, really think that you will be phenomenally successful. Don't be afraid to work hard. Don't be afraid to dream big. You know, part of being a successful entrepreneur is the lifestyle. You will have it. And I wish each and every one of you the very best in your career, in your life. And I hope to see all of you as great entrepreneurs. Thank you. Now it's my duty to introduce another great entrepreneur whom I know well, Mr. Murugavel Janakiraman. He's the founder CEO of a company that all of you, now since I talked about marriage, it was purposeful. His company is Bharat Matrimony. Mr. Murugavel Janakiraman, the founder CEO of Bharat Matrimony, is among the early tech entrepreneurs of India who has helped millions of people experience the joy and love of matrimony using the power of internet. From a one-man show, and I repeat, from a one-man show, Murugavel has built his flagship into the most successful matrimony brand in the world. Bharat Matrimony is all over the world, making a positive, lasting difference to the lives of millions in several countries. Murugavel's inspiring achievement and success in the internet space has won him several awards and honors. He was honored by the Asian Indian Chamber of Commerce as one of the top 5 Asian Indian businessmen in United States below the age of 35. Murugavel was also recognized by India Today Group as the Business Icon of the Year and given the Udyog Ratan Award by the Institute of Economic Studies. Recently, he was awarded the CII Connect Award by the Confederation of Indian Industries for playing a significant role at the global event in the ICT sector. Murugavel was voted the Digital Entrepreneur of the Year at the WAT Awards in January 2012. He's a postgraduate in computer science from University of Madras, from our own Madras. Murugavel started his career with a software company in Chennai. He worked as a consultant in Singapore and in the US for leading companies before starting a small website that would become the world's largest matrimony service. Murugavel is also committed to multiple social causes and helping save lives to saving the environment. Again, all entrepreneurs have several purposes, not just to make money. He champions the cause of eye donation and runs Bharat Eye Bank. He also runs Bharat Blood Bank, a non-profit initiative. Ability Matrimony is an exclusive matrimony site for singles with special needs or those wanting to marry someone with special needs. It's my privilege to invite Mr. Murugavel Janakiraman to share his success story with you all.
Good afternoon. I didn't know that when Raju told me that, Muruga, can you go after me? I said, okay, Raju, not a problem. I didn't realize that you want to do a trailer of BharatMatrimony.com. He asked how many people want to get married in the next 5 years, how many people want to get married. He left how they want to get married. It is through BharatMatrimony.com. It must be through BharatMatrimony. I just want to kind of decode what is entrepreneurship in 6 letters. Okay, I'll just relate how our journey kind of started and what we are doing today and how we have grown. When people talk about entrepreneurship, they talk about think big, start small. No. I don't know, wrong kind of misconception about that, the entrepreneurship. People say, like, think big, start small. See, when you come to a certain stage, today Raju can start with the thinking that you can think big and start small, because after years of experience, you know, you have that kind of bandwidth, understanding of the business and all the thing. Today, anything you start, we know that it's going to be a few hundred crore business, but it'll start small. You want to do the pilot, you want to understand before expanding. But as an entrepreneur, somebody starting for the first time, and many times people don't start or get into entrepreneurship because they know, I got to think of some big idea. No. Many companies, today we take the world largest companies, Walmart. Walmart not started as thinking that one day they'll become the world largest retailer. When Sam Walton started Walmart, it was a dime store. It took after 15 years for him to start one retail store in the rural America. After so many years, after he fine-tuned the model, then the expansion happened. Beat many companies, Google, they all started as a kind of research project. Apple, it just wanted to make some money. All the company today become a very successful company. They did not start with the thinking that they're going to become so big. The first learning is called, I call SS. Start small, think small. The first learning about entrepreneurship is about the letter S. So think small or start small. Don't wait for the big idea. In 1997, after studied in India, went to US, I want to do something on my own. It's a many entrepreneurs face the problem of want to do something, they don't know what to do, what to start. I looked at, say, let me do on Tamil site. I come from Tamil Nadu. There are a lot of Tamilians in US. Targeting the Tamil community, what are the services which can provide? I went on the internet. When I looked at, there are a lot of already Tamil sites were targeting the Tamil community in the US. I looked into, look, what are the services which they are not providing, which you can leverage through my strength. My strength, a single most strength that point of time was, I was very good in programming. So your core strength definitely helps. I started doing certain things which can be of use for the Tamil community, like Tamil daily calendar, Tamil discussion forum, Tamil greeting cards, Tamil make friends. I introduced matrimony as one of the section. My friends used to kind of tease at me, what are you doing? You know, you're developing on Tamil website, you're spending money, though no revenue model. Look, I want to do something on my own. I'm enjoying what I'm doing. Every day the visitors are coming to website. It's my responsibility to kind of keep them happy, and I kept on adding additional features. I had to go to the grocery stores in US. I go to the movie theater, distribute flyers. This I was working as a consultant doing in the part time. It took 2.5 years for me to identify the opportunity, the matrimony space. The matrimony section which I had in the Tamil community website sort of becoming attractive, getting more traffic and all that thing. It took 2.5 years for me to identify the opportunity. I think people want to get married to the same language speaking person. We're running a Tamil site. People are coming for this matrimony section because they want to get married. A Tamilian wants to marry a Tamilian. I initially wanted to do only Tamil and Telugu because I come from Chennai. Chennai also has a lot of Telugu people. Then before launching the website in April 2004 on Tamil New Year's Day, I said same technology, same, you know, kind of back and everything. Launched all the matrimony website, like language-based matrimony website, Tamil matrimony, Telugu matrimony, Kerala matrimony, under the brand called Bharat Matrimony. So first thing about, if you don't know what to do, keep experimenting, keep experimenting, keep experimenting, and you'll find the idea which attracts you. Think small, start small. That's the first learning. Second thing is about letter P. It's called passion and perseverance. Whatever you do, if you don't have passion in what you do, it's more like struggling, you know, kind of every day going to the work will be a struggle. Every day doing thing. Entrepreneurship board, as Raji said, it's a lot of hard work, commitment, challenge, so many things. You need to, when you enjoy what you do, what that's called passion. What makes it, for me, going to office is not more, you know, we look for a Monday morning. So you're passionate about what you do. So if you identify something, the blessed are those, they get the chance to work or do what they like. A simple thing is, for Ilaraja, music is not a work. He passionately does, kind of. So it is about, when you're passionate about it, whatever you do, entrepreneur, any business, anything, when you're passionate about it, you don't even feel you're working. You're just flowing along with the flow. You're not resisting. When you're resisting, when you're tired, when you're doing something against your interest, something against your will, that's the time you feel, you know, tired. Do you need to go to office today? Do you need to do this business ordering? The passion is important. Just being passionate alone is not sufficient. The perseverance, very, very important. Thomas Alva Edison said, many great failures in life are, people did not know how close they were to the success when they gave up. I call it the imaginary finishing line, which I learned from my guru. Many times you feel that, looks, I think it's at the end. I'm going to give up. It's not happening. It's a struggle. I think I ought to give up. You might have seen, you know, you're all studying and all those things. Example which you can easily understand. When you're studying, there are points at which you feel, I cannot study anymore. I need to close my eyes to kind of fall asleep. You might have experienced this one. Another 10 minutes, another 15 minutes, another some more time, we'd have continued study till the morning also. People who are jogging, they know that. If you are jogging for some time, you feel that movement at which you feel, I cannot run anymore. Another understep, they can run for. People who do the regular jogging, they know that. It's called imaginary finishing line. The business, you face many challenges. It's not giving up. It's really matter. They're called perseverance, very, very important quality. In fact, one great quality I talk about is not about being passionate, but pursuer, not giving up. Keep experimenting, keep doing different things. They know that it's not the end, it's a beautiful bend and all the thing. Second letter is the P, the passion and the perseverance. Because when you run a business, many challenges you have faced. It's not that, you know, kind of today what you are and all the thing without. There are days I think, look, it's going to be the end. And it's not giving up what will lead to become what you are today. Many, many situations. And also want to pass on one more learning is called unintended consequences will produce far better results than intended consequences. Many times we'll get concerned, upset that the plan is not going as per our plan. And you have to realize that these are unintended consequences. Certain consequences are happening in spite of you putting the best results. When the results are not up to what you're expecting, you have to understand that God has a different plan. You may realize that many of those failures, when you look back, would have given certain learning, certain understanding. In my life, I can go so many examples. Today, if things does not go as per our plan, I always have that understanding, unintended consequences will produce far better than intended consequences. I want to get BSc chemistry after my plus two, want to be a laboratory technician, because coming from the background of first one to go to IU school in my family, I didn't get BSc chemistry. What I got a BSc statistics. But God has a different plan for me. I want chemistry, God gave me the statistics. In finally a BSc statistics, when I want to apply for MCA, a chemistry was not eligible to apply, whereas statistics were eligible to apply. In 2001, I want to get full-time in the business, but I was supporting business of having married through Bharat Matrimony, married to Bharat Matrimony, and you know, constructing first house, come from middle class family. I was kept on postponing my decision of coming to business full-time. Thankfully, I got laid off. Unintended consequences. Many instances, even the earth system in 2008, when the slowdown has happened, for many companies, many organizations, globally, it was a very challenging. Till 2008, I was an entrepreneur. The 2008 challenge made me a CEO. The challenge which I went through in 2008, facing multiple things, how to be a cost efficient, how you can negotiate stronger, again, unintended consequences. So passion and perseverance are very important. Second learning. Third is when you started a product or service, whatever it is, how do you make yourself the best in the world? Be it Apple, be it a Walmart, any successful company, they follow this letter called I. Imitation and innovation. Imitate. If you find good ideas, imitate. Adapt the idea. See whether how that idea can be adapted into your business. Innovate. Keep innovating. So that will make you having the world-class service or product. We've done so much of innovation in the matrimony space. So many innovation. We are really different the way people getting married. Virtual matrimony meet. And you look at a profile matching someone. You can search profile like your favorite actor, actress. Very interesting feature we've done. Lot of innovation. We've done innovation on technology innovation, value innovation, which probably talk about at the end. So many innovation we've done. So third letter is I, imitation and innovation. The fourth is letter called K. Keep fixing and keep improving. Because of the business progress, certain things, system and process, what you have put up, it may not be kind of work as you progress and all the thing. Challenge the status quo all the time. You have to keep fixing, keep finding the gap, and keep fixing. Don't assume things are the way it and all the thing. Continuously go back, question why it has to be like that, why it cannot be like that, why things cannot be done better. So you see the gaps. As you business progress, you keep finding more and more gaps and all the thing. You have to keep fixing those gaps. Then thing is keep improving. Keep improving what? In many aspects. Process expert, system expert, people expert. You are being yourself as an entrepreneur. I was as an entrepreneur in 2000. As just a programmer, become entrepreneur. Today I can say that I'm an entrepreneur with all the record qualities of to run the business at the current level. Does not guarantee that tomorrow when the company become few thousand crores, this current skills will be sufficient enough for me to run that few thousand crore organization. I need to continuously develop myself. So as the business grows, you have to keep improving all the aspect. What was a strength one point of time can become a weakness. You have to get the right people, the people who have taken to a certain level, that people may not be good enough to take to the next level. So everything about you have to keep learning. So keep improving is an ongoing thing. The fourth thing is the K, keep fixing and keep improving. The fifth is letter called E. You know that it's hard work, effort and effectiveness. Obviously, to make the business successful, a lot of effort required. You have to continuously put the best effort in all those things. It's not effort alone. Effort has to combine with effectiveness. Imagine you want to create a well. You can't go and desert and put the effort and expect the well to come. The well has to be constructed in the right place. Skill is not effort alone. It's combined with effectiveness. So entrepreneurship is about effort combined with effectiveness. Being smart. Keep learning, keep improving, whatever thing, all the thing. The effectiveness can get the desired result. It's not effort alone get the results. All these things, five letters I talked about. Starting, thinking small, starting small, which help you to kind of kickstart a business. Having the passion and perseverance. Imitation and innovation help you to kind of create a world-class product. Keep fixing, keep improving, help you to kind of grow the business. And effort and effectiveness, which help you to kind of get the desired results. And finally, it's all create a limited amount of success. But as an entrepreneur, we have to keep asking the one final thing about what next, what more. As I said, it was a Tamil site in 1997, became matrimony site in the year 2000. Till 2006, it was a matrimony, bharatmatrimony.com. The entire effort went into kind of building the bharatmatrimony.com. Then 2006, we thought, we become highly successful matrimony. We had to expand into various other verticals. We got into India property. We got into jobs portal. So many other things. Later realized that so much opportunity in the core category. Thankfully, IndiaProperty.com became a highly successful property portal. So always asking the question of what next, what more. In the 2008, the challenge led to multiple innovation. Today, what BharatMatrimony.com was in 2008. Within matrimony space, we are running 9 businesses. So all the way you had the question, what next, what more, what next, what more. It also leads to an interesting learning. Expansion is possible within the core category. Many times people think expansion means they can need to get into different industry or different category. Within matrimony, how we have launched so many businesses. 2008, it was only bharatmatrimony.com. Today, we are one of the largest retailers in India, running 200 company-owned Bharat Matrimony outlets across India. We are one of the largest retailer. Then for the busy people, in the membership, bharatmatrimony.com is today 2,990 for 3 months. But you knew that management graduates going to make a lot of money. Why these people also need to pay 2,990? They can afford, they can pay more. Again, you had to have the value-added services for people. Instead of you doing for searching by yourself, you are so busy, you may not have time to do the searching of life partner, outsource the responsibility to us. We have a service called Privilege Matrimony. Instead of you doing the searching, our relationship manager, who are very smart, they'll say you have time, effort and all those things. We created a business called Privilege Matrimony and assisted matchmaking service business. We are able to charge 19,000 rupees for 3 months by just putting the value added service. Then there are rich and affluent people. These people can pay more than the common people, but they need a special service. We launched a service called Elite Matrimony for rich and affluent people. Exclusive service for those people, 50,000 rupees for 3 months. Even your service called Elite Premium, 2 lakhs for 3 months. So 2,990 package for 3 months become all the way up to 2 lakhs for 3 months. Then we realized that Bharat Matrimony is a language-based matrimony site, Tamil matrimony, Telugu matrimony, Kerala matrimony. But you all know that marriage happened within the community. Create your own competition before someone come and creates. That's what FMC does. Wheel and surf, all from interest on Unilever. Many FMC, they create a own competition in the process of conquering more market share. We realize that what can we have the strong competition in Bharat Matrimony? It is community matrimony set. We created 300 plus community matrimony set. Iyer Matrimony, Agarwal Matrimony, Patel Matrimony. Everything in community where like-minded people want to get married. Diversity matrimony also community. 40 plus matrimony community, defense matrimony community. We created 300 plus community matrimony site. It's become a competition to Bharat Matrimony. Today, it is the third largest matrimony site. So, fourth business, Bharat Matrimony, Privilege Matrimony, Elite Matrimony, Retail Matrimony, Community Matrimony, fifth matrimony site. Then we created other business. Why only you had to help Indians to get married? Yan Petra Vindam Purivai Vayagam. You launch Pakistani matrimony, Arab matrimony, but they can get married 4 times, okay? So, good business opportunity. Arab matrimony, we launch Bangla matrimony, we launch Sri Lankan matrimony. Then we also realized that matchmaking, yes, it's a service. I want to call it business, the business outcome of what you do. It's a one service, it's a, as long as humanity exists. Imagine a business where you are part of its service. One business, it will be there as long as humanity exists. There's no recession at all. So business, and people come and thank, you know, kind of, thank you, it's, you know, kind of, people say, use the services, then also, we also feel equally blessed to kind of hear the success stories. So recession proof, as long as the world exists, this business will exist, and people come and thank, and we also equally feel blessed about the service. Being part of that thing, we know that matchmaking is going to be very long, but matrimony is a very big opportunity. People spend a lot of money on marriage. It's a few hundred billion dollar business. How to get the better market share of this thing? Slowly started expanding from matchmaking into the matrimony space. We launched matrimonygifts.com, e-commerce initiative. And when you're working on the matrimonygifts.com, you realize that a Tambulya gift, and people give the Tambulya gifts, it's an opportunity. We set up our India's first exclusive return gift store, Tambulya. We recently opened in Chennai. We expanded into a product-based retailing also. All I want to say is that today, in the matrimony space, we are running 9 business. The seed for all those things was a small community site, a one-man show, a developer, HTML, graphic designer, all was done by me for 2.5 years. It's 2.5 years is a single man show without knowing what is the business idea. The starting small, thinking small, led to Tamil Matrimony, Telugu Matrimony. That led to from Bharat Matrimony, India Property and other verticals. From within Matrimony, from all the things, 200 retail outlets. Ah, we also launched Popular Matrimony. I forgot to mention. What is Popular Matrimony? Look, you are targeting only the people who are computer or, you know, people who are English speaking or who can use computer internet. What are the people at the bottom of the pyramid? People who attend a school education. We recently launched a Popular Matrimony, a fortune at the bottom of the pyramid. There's a book, S.C.K. Prahlad, opportunity at the bottom of the pyramid. Again, for us, not only the opportunities, also to service those people, the housemates, auto driver, those people. We launched a service called Popular Matrimony. It's a marriage bureau format. Our subscription for them is 500 rupees. 3 months, people can come at our services. Covering all aspects, horizontally and vertically. Popular Matrimony, 500 rupees. Bharat Matrimony, Privileged Matrimony, Elite Matrimony. It's called vertical segmentation. Sorry, horizontal segmentation. Vertical segmentation, community-specific vertical segmentation. IR, IR, Mudaliar, Defense, all those things. So much of expansion can be possible in core category. Sum it up. Entrepreneurship, nothing. I come from the background of if parents who are not even gone to school. My father studied 3rd standard, mother did not even study. I first one to go to IE school in my family. Till 10th standard in Tamil medium. It's just this, all 6 letters we talked about. Thinking small, starting small. Passion and perseverance. Imitate and innovate. Keep fixing, keep improvising. Effort and effectiveness. Finally, what next, what more? With that, my best wishes, so much opportunity. If we follow these 6 things, we can be highly successful. It's nothing. Everybody can be successful. What really matters that following the principle I talked about all the thing. Wish you all the best. Thank you.
Let's give a big round of applause to Murugavel. You know, it's fascinating to hear a real life story. He calls it Spike, what next, what more? Small, passion, intimate, imitate, innovate, keep fixing, effort. Wow. It was really very exciting to see the way he has grown it. We have another great entrepreneur who is going to be talking to you all. And that's Mr. Venkatesh, Managing Director and CEO of Goli Vada Pav Private Limited. How many of you have heard Vada Pav? How many of you have tasted it? I'm from Bombay and I used to buy Vada Pav from a train station. No, just a bread with a bonda with some chutney. And Venkatesh has already sold over 7 crores of Vada Pav already. He is a BCom graduate, formerly a business executive in the financial services, worked there for about 15 plus years and started Vada Pav, Goli Vada Pav. Goli is the first Indian company in the ethnic food segment which has worked on the back end, and all various types of vadas are made in a fully automated plant. Every vada passes through a metal detector and an X-ray machine to ensure that the product is of international standard. Now, you will think a vada pav is easy to make, right? Goli vada pav aims to impart an ethnic status to the humble vada.
Good afternoon. I want this good afternoon with a lot of enthusiasm. That's not enough. Good afternoon. I use the word enthusiasm in Latin. Yeah. Enthu is a beautiful word in Latin. En means inside and tu means God. Once you invoke the God within you, you are bound to generate a lot of energy, isn't it? And what is entrepreneurship? Entrepreneurship is basically an intangible idea in your mind, and you put a lot of your enthusiasm and energy and passion in it, and that idea becomes something tangible, isn't it? So I want a small promise from all of you. Whatever we do today, in the next 40 minutes, I want all of you to practice enthusiasm. And how do you practice enthusiasm? Every 5 minutes after I complete one session and something that touches your heart, I want all of you to celebrate with a lot of claps. Is it a promise? So can we have a small round of applause for all the speakers before me? How many of you have heard about Paulo Coelho? It's a beautiful, wonderful, awesome book. And this particular sentence in Paulo Coelho's book is great for all entrepreneurs. You have a dream. The dream has come in the womb of the universe. It is the responsibility of the universe to fulfill the dream. The universe conspires to help you achieve your dream. You have a dream. The dream has come in the womb of the universe. It is the responsibility of the universe to fulfill the dream. The universe conspires to help you achieve your dream. Whatever Paulo Coelho has said in the past, our own Mahatma Gandhi has said, you find the purpose, the means will follow. You have an idea, you have a passion, you have a faith in the idea, don't wait for 15 years, the way Raju said. Just think and get going. And how many of you read about Richard Bach, Jonathan Livingstone, the seagull? How many of you? If some of you have not read, go ahead and buy the book. It's a story of a small little seagull which wants to fly like a eagle. Normally, seagulls don't fly in the air. Seagull's flight is restricted to food. Kitne uchai pe? 15 feet. Seagulls don't fly beyond 15 feet. And their flight or flying is restricted to food. They fight for dead fishes amongst their family and friends. Amongst them was our hero, Jonathan, who looked at the eagle and said, I too want to fly like a eagle. And there was a small fictional, right? It's a fictional story. A mountain around the shore where his family used to be there and friends. He used to climb that 10,000 feet high, you know, mountain and go to the top of the mountain and from there look at the eagle. He used to look at the eagle. It's like a small middle class boy somewhere here. He's got an idea in his mind. He looks at the Tatas, the Birlas, the Infosys, the Wipro. And then he says, can I build an enterprise like them, but middle class people? So he explores the market, reaches the top of the mountain, and from there, the seagull looks at the eagle and says, wow, it looks great. But from 10,000 feet high, to throw yourself into the winds of the ocean from 10,000 feet high, how the winds will be there? It's risky. It requires a lot of courage. Entrepreneurship looks beautiful, idea looks beautiful, but to leave that great job in Infosys, Wipro or ICICI and go and jump into the world of entrepreneurship is what? Risky. So, Paulo Coelho has got the beautiful word. He's got one sentence in his book. The language of the world is written in one single word, and the word is called courage, courage and courage. Yes, for entrepreneurship, if risk is a word, courage is the next supporting word. And one day, Jonathan, after 6 months of looking at the eagle, said enough, and he threw himself into the winds of the ocean at 10,000 feet high. He came crashing and hit the brick-like ocean. All his feathers got torn. His body started aching. And the oceanic waves brought him back to the shore. As he reached the shore, he was lying unconscious. His father, his mother, his family, they all came and said, I told you, don't do this. leave this flying business for the big eagle. If at all you are there, you did your engineering, you did your MBA, or chinna Infosys la job, or chinna Wipro la job. In the entrepreneurship business, you should have left it to Murthys and the Tatas and Reddys and taken up a small job. Jonathan wakes up and starts climbing towards the mountain and threw himself once more, twice, thrice, four. He failed n number of times, and one day Jonathan flew. Yes, my friends, this is the story of most of the entrepreneurs. There are very few entrepreneurs who become successful in their first round, in their first exploration. For all those people who got a little Jonathan in their mind, in this hall, can we give them a big applause? So the first stage I said was enthusiasm. Without enthusiasm, no idea can be transformed. You know, zombies can't convert ideas into business. Are you with me? Zombies can't convert. And to prove that you are not zombies, I want that round of applause. Can we get? Are you all awake? Only alert and awake people can become entrepreneurs. I want that round of clap so that you are all awake. Zombies are bomb. After the inspiration comes the idea. When we started a business, I am a typical socialistic person. So I looked at education, employment and entrepreneurship. You know, if you get into a business, it has to generate education for the poor, it has to create employment, it also has to create entrepreneurship out of the poor and the middle people. That was the thought process. The idea stage. So we completed the enthusiasm, we went through the inspiration, and now the idea stage. My mobile ringtone is to this famous song. Chodo kalki baate, kalki baat purani, naye daur mein likhenge hum milkar nayi kahani, hum Hindustani. Have you heard? I'm Hindustani, I'm Hindustani. It's a 1970s feel, that song. And I used to start the day with a Colgate paste. I'm Hindustani. A Gillette razor, I'm Hindustani. A Lux soap, I'm Hindustani. All transnational, multinationals. A Nokia mobile, I'm Hindustani. A Ray-Ban glass. A cross pen. And I used to wonder, is my Hindustan? Kahan hai? So at the idea stage, it had to be a Hindustani brand. I had to get into a Hindustani brand. Those days, the Kellogg CEO used to be my neighbor. And one day after being 10 years with Kellogg's, he left Kellogg's and went somewhere abroad. So somewhere in his send-off party, he muttered, Kuch bhi karo yaar, Hindustani aadmi desi hi kaata hai. Whatever you do, the Indians will have a Ray-Ban sunglasses. He may use a Colgate paste, but when it comes to food, he likes to eat spicy Indian food. And suddenly it hit upon me, my God, ethnic food is a great opportunity. I was looking out for opportunities and idea. And ethnic food, a 100 crores plus population, weakness for spicy Indian food. Even 50 crores population you target, and saal mein ek baar you give a 10 rupee item, it becomes a 500 crore opportunity. In a year, 10 times he consumes the product, it becomes a 5000 crore opportunity. So after the idea stage, the entrepreneur looks at opportunity. How big is the market size? He starts looking at it. It may be a reality, it may be a fiction, or it may not happen. But that opportunity excites him at the idea stage. So it was Indian brand, it had to be an ethnic food. Ethnic food mein kare to kya kare? Are you all awake? Proof, proof. Yeah. Ethnic food mein kare to kya kare? So Kashmir to Kanyakumari, India has got a lot of food. This is a country in country, you know. North you have got aloo paratha, samosa. West you have got belpuri, ragda petis, vada pav. South you have got idli, sambar. Kare to kya kare? There was a confusion. You know, at the idea stage. And one day outside a VT station, where I normally Mumbai, I am Mumbai, I saw that huge 40 feet plus Mac M with a huge burger photo. What was it? A burger photo, 40 feet plus banner. And below him was a Telawala. Telawala is the Ancard guy, you know, with a banyan and a lehenga in Mumbai. 56 volt we call it, chappan tikli banyan. You know, he was frying his vadas. Because vada pav in Mumbai is like normally done by the lower middle class, the slum dweller guy who gets into a hand cart and starts making the bonda in the evening. Puts it inside a pav and gives it to you. It's a very lowly item. And as I picked my vada pav, as usual, Mumbaiites eat vada pav throughout the day. I suddenly saw this as like a twin brother story. They were looking like a twin brother somewhere, you know. I was looking out for an idea. I had become very frustrated, what is it that I should do? And then it was like a twin brother story. Have you heard about Ram or Sham 1970 movie? Judwa Bhai, Bollywood. That is anything between bun. This is anything between pav. That is mayonnaise. This is chutney. That is lettuce. This is mirchi. that is non-spicy, this is spicy. So from that I felt, it's like a twin brother story. One guy goes to America and becomes a super siege success story, 40,000 plus outlet. The other brother is lying on the footpath of Mumbai, Garib. You know, so somewhere it was like that Ram or Sham story. And somewhere I felt this is a role model for us. This is a role model. Why twin brother? It's not only the form, even the content is the same. India is changing. Most of the India is becoming urban. And the wives no more cook the food the way my mother, my wife or my grandmother would have cooked. The wives are all into BPO, IT and other career. The kitchen has shrunk. Okay? And urban mobile population has got time for everything but for food. But for sabke liye time hai, but we don't have time to eat food. And 5 minutes is what maximum you can wait to get his food in a hotel or any other place. 5 minutes, can you service outside a Dadar station or outside a Chennai station or outside Bangalore 50 masala dosas? Can you serve? Not possible. 5 minutes, can you serve 50 pani puris? 5 minutes, you can easily fry a vada or a bonda in Mumbai footpath. It comes in 5 minutes, 50 bondas from a big kadai. You just have to cut the pav and put it inside it and give it to the customer. So it fell into a definition of a fast food. It fell into a definition of a fast food. At the idea stage, you have to eliminate. If I had a wrong product, we would have been sunk by now. It fell into a definition of fast food. Second, it's a finger food. Finger food in the sense, you can take a vada pav, it doesn't require plate and spoon. The moment you have a dosa or a idli, it requires plate and spoon, sambar and chutney. Or plate and spoon, you require table and chair. And real estate is very, very costly in urban areas. Is real estate a big problem? And you have suddenly 10 people eating vada pav for 10 rupees and they don't get up for 1 hour. What do? You can throw them out. So for a low price product, the table and chair becomes very, very costly. So fast food, finger food. And since it's a finger food, it's also a mobile food. In Mumbai, you would have seen a lot of people, they from Borivali to Churchgate, they cling outside a railway train and eat a vada pav. In a life and death situation, but they will have a vada pav. Can you eat a masala dosa clinging outside a train? Is it possible? I want response. Can you eat a pani puri and drive a rickshaw? Can you eat a grilled sandwich and say to the tomato, bhai sahab, aadha kilo tomato de dena? Is it possible? With vada pav, it's possible. People eat a vada pav and they do everything. They go to talk on the mobile, they drive a rickshaw, they cling outside a railway train because it's a fast food, finger food and a mobile food. And the most important thing, the core content of the food. Most of the common people, they go by form. They don't go by content. Everybody say, will vada pav sell outside Mumbai? But what is the core content of vada pav? Potato and wheat. Potato and wheat. In this all, we say, how many people don't like palak? How many people don't like palak? Yes, there is some 8-10 hands I can see. How many people don't like ladies finger? Bendi? There is few hands. How many people don't like potato? One or two guys, throw him out of the hall. Potato is a universal food. Finger chips is potato. Wafers is potato. Puri bhaji is potato. Masala dosa is potato. Samosa is potato. Alu paratha is potato. How many? It's a universal appeal. So the product had to have a Amitabh Bachchan quality or a Rajinikanth quality in itself. And potato has got that quality of Rajinikanth and Amitabh Bachchan. Mass appeal. Are you with me? It had to be a mass appeal. After potato and wheat, there is besan. Besan na enna theriyuma? Ellarku Tamil puriyum illaya? How many people understand Tamil? Everybody? Okay. I am a Mumbai Tamilian. So a lot of my Tamil has become, you know, Hindi, English, Tamil mix. Besan means gram. And batata vada has got a coating of what? Vada pav's vada is cutting a coating of gram. Gram is also got a universal appeal in India. It's specific to India. In South, you have Mysore Pak. What is it made of? Ghee and besan. You go to North, Son Papdi. What is it made of? Besan. Haldiram ne thoda sa besan liya, gram liya, tel mein dal diya. He put it inside the oil and then put some spices. It's become a 1,000 crore empire. That's the kind of weakness we Indians have got for gram. So your product has to have a pan-India appeal. That's why we went through this. Why vada pav? So at the idea stage, don't jump guns. Keep on working on the idea. Some businesses work by experience, some businesses work by idea. The idea itself works on its own. Why brand name Goli? A lot of people used to say, Venki, English is aspirational. What is it? English is aspirational. The name has to be English. Imagine Nalli Sari called Julie Sari. Will you buy it? Nalli Sari or Julie Sari Chana, will you buy it? I want yes or no. Murugan Idli, we call Peter Idli. Will you buy it? So, Vada Pav was born on the footpath of Mumbai. And the Mumbai language or the lingo is, you know what? Pudi, Rapchik, Item, Munnabai, Goli. So, we gave it a Mumbaiya street lingo, Goli, Vada Pav. Are you all with me? Hey, it requires some applause at this stage. Alive. Sometimes, in India, we have this typical name and surname. We always felt that Goli shouldn't become much powerful than Vada Pav. So Goli was our name and Vada Pav was our surname. But as a company, we can't get the rights of Vada Pav as a name. So we always called ourselves Goli Vada Pav. And we rode on a brand called Vada Pav. We always felt, a lot of people used to say, Venki, you are getting into FMCG space, you are getting into retail space, pocket level of paisa irukku. He hardly had any money in the pocket. But we were sure that Vada Pav name is like Amitabh Bachchan. It will attract attention. On its own, it will sell. It's like Indira Gandhi. If Indira had married a person called Rao or Patel, we don't know how that plan would have survived till date. She had a powerful name behind her. What was it? Gandhi, the most powerful name. Even now, the clan is continuing to be part of our political system. So the same way, Goli rode on a name called Vada Pav. The first store started in Kalyan 2004. Red garam garam batata vada, white cleanliness, and then we put that moustache and the topi, the Indian man, the Maharashtrian man or the Indian man, to show we are desi street food. And green is spiciness. So everything was communicated in a very subtle way. Hot batata vada, what are the virtues of a vada pav? Garam garam, spicy, and then we also said we are clean. We are not like the street vendors. The first few stores happened automatically. This was our kitchen those days. A central kitchen from where we used to manufacture this product. I want to know zombies or atom bomb. Claps. Louder, yeah. This is not atom bomb. Much. So this was our manual kitchen those days. This was our manual kitchen. And from here we used to manufacture the vadas by hand. This was the logistics when we started in 2004. And this was the store. Just by putting tiles, just by putting uniform, just by putting posters, can Vada Pav become burger? Aisa hota to everybody would have started a Vada Pav chain. And somewhere I started becoming restless. I knew things would go wrong. And within the first 2 years, we realized after 10-12 stores, the product doesn't have a shelf life. Kartala or Ekkaira Bonda Panungo, by evening, 3000 Bonda is waste. Because it doesn't have a shelf life, it will get spoiled. So wastage was our biggest issue. So from a central kitchen, we used to supply 8,000 bondas. The product didn't have a shelf life. The very important part for economics or commerce. Wastage can kill your business. Second, pilferage. We used to supply 1,000 bondas or vadas to all our franchisees. The boys at the store will make 2,000 bondas out of that. And we gave us money for only 1,000. Pilferage was the biggest issue. Third was non-standardization. As the mood of the chef changed, the taste is to change. Are you all with me? The most crucial part was the wastage, pilferage, standardization and price fluctuation. 30% of our revenue collected is to go in wastage, pilferage, non-standardization and price fluctuation. My banker raised hand and said, Kadaya Mudidu. You are very happy, 10 stores, but your balance sheet looks bad. He gave me 10 days, sort out your matter. Luckily in Mumbai, I have good friends in IIT, VJTI and all. I started talking to them. We went to Amul and tried to do the ultraviolet rays technology to increase the shelf life. You know, Amul Dood, Amul Lassi. But it worked for milk, but it was not working for potatoes. We tried the nitrogen gas chambers like Lays. Have you heard about Lays? Lays, no, it's got a good shelf life, 4 to 5 months. We tried that technology because it was also potato. That also didn't work very good for us. We tried the blast chill. By this time, my PF, whatever was there, my past gratuity was there. shares was there, the house got mortgaged, the gold was about to be got mortgaged. My co-founder was very strong. One day he used to buy gold, bring gold from his sister. Then one day I asked him after a week, whose gold is this? He said, my sister's neighbor's gold. So he started borrowing money from everybody. So the passion sometimes make you mad. My banker was very angry. He told, last 10 days, kadaya, mudidungo. As a desperate measure and a passion for this business, I somehow went to the people who make burgers for McDonald's. It's called OSI. What is it called? The company which makes burgers for McDonald's. And in India, the company is called Vista Food. They make burgers for McDonald's. They have some present in 33 countries. It's a 50-year-old company. It's one of the oldest company. We went and told our story to them and indirectly asked them, can you help us? You don't go to Mukesh Ambani and tell, give your son as a marriage alliance to my daughter. Do you tell them? We are too small, 10 stores. These are the world's largest food company. But when you have passion, you have madness. So we went and made a small presentation, talked to them. And they were also mad people. Within a month, they came with a board resolution from Chicago, McDonald's and OSI and said, we are partners. And with this, I need some applause at this stage. Are you all listening? Wow. OSI is the world's largest food company. 1955, it was forged a partnership with McDonald's. 33 countries they are present. It's one of the oldest manufacturer and the largest food company in the world. And with this association, Batata Vada, which was being done on the gutters of Mumbai, started being done on a fully automatic plant. With every vada going through a metal detector, X-ray machine, no human hand touching it, mixing, patty making, basin, coating, no human hand was touching it, blasting, counting, packaging, and putting a refer van and going to the cold room. The destiny of the street food changed with being made in a 50 crore fully automatic with an American joint venture for Vada Pav. We were at a stage where things were looking bleak, we were closed down, and Paulo Coelho's beautiful words, you have a dream, the dream has come in the womb of the universe, it's the responsibility of the universe to fulfill the dream. In the Western world, they call it strategy, in India we can call it destiny. Are you with me? The Western world calls it strategy, in India we can call it destiny, karma, whatever it is there, but there is some science behind all this that happens. Vadas made in a fully automatic plant. With this, it became like a Colgate paste, a Lux soap, or a Lace, or a Bingo. Manufacturing date, expiry date. Coimbatore, somebody is eating a vada pav, and so he finds something not right with the vada. We can track the vada, which truck the vada came from, cold room, which cold room it was stored, which factory it was manufactured, who was the supervisor, and from which farm the potatoes came. Imagine doing it for vada pav, a 10 rupee poor urban street food. Frozen logistics, these are how we started sending. The fryer which we used to have normal, used to fry a normal vada, but a minus 18 temperature vada had to be fried differently. And we got an Infosys guy to do a software, we got a VJTA guy to do the instrumentation, and this fryer in 15,000 fries the bonda. You know what? 170 the flame starts, 180 the flames goes away, tongue temperature is 70, viscosity of the basin is 90. That's the kind of standardization we got for vada pav with these fryers. Fryer became very simpler, so we didn't require cook at the store level. The difference became this. First challenge happened, we solved the material problem. Now came the next problem. Our banker said, material is done, but pocket like a paisa. Where is the money? We started talking to various investment bankers, we started talking to PEs, we started talking to HNIs, but everybody say, what is Goli? Because we were in some god-forsaken place in Kalyan, you know, remotest part of Mumbai. It's called the poor man's Mumbai, you know, Kalyan, Dombivli, Ulasnagar. And we have not heard about Goli. And then the next thing that we knew, Vada Pav was like Amitabh Bachchan. We just had to tell the press. One day, disappointedly, in my jeans, t-shirt and slipper, I and my co-founder took a taxi from VT to go back to Kalyan or, you know, New Bombay, where I stay. And suddenly, outside VT station, I saw Times of India. We stopped the taxi on the flyover, walked down. The first guy was smoking a cigarette and drinking a cutting chai. I went and blabbered my story. I told him, I want somebody from Times of India to come to our kitchen and see what we are trying to do. He said, tomorrow morning, open the newspaper. And this was Mumbai's vada pav to get American touch. The media picked up the story like anything. And within a span of 1 month, I didn't have to go to the investors. The investors came to Kalyan. And that's why I say in entrepreneurship, everything has to be done by the promoters or the founders at the starting stage. Material problem, you have to solve. Money problem, you have to solve. Marketing problem, you have to solve. Jab mein paisa nahi karke baith nahi sakta hai. Anytime as you see a Star TV or NDTV guy on the road, go and tell them the story. People said, kya tu rukta nahi hai karke? But within a span of 1 month, this was told. And fundraising happened. We selected the American backend partner. Same way I felt, we had some IIT, IIMs, Citibank people. Out of all the investors who came, stockbroker, big retailer, we selected them because we wanted credibility for Vada Pav. In India, what is it, you know? Our onnume panaliyo, our samel karna adva. You don't do anything in life, you go and do, become a cook or you start a hotel business. That's the kind of tradition. Food is relegated to the bottommost. All the IITs will go to Infosys, Wipro, IT. All of them will go to Citibank as a second option. But we still don't have machines for Vada, Bonda, Jangri, Tairi Chadam. There is no machine. But the Americans have converted everything into mechanization. That's how we can do the brands. So we said, Vada Pav requires credibility to become a corporate. So we got this IIT, IIM, Citibank people to invest. And it got some credibility. The whole thought process was to give credibility to the Vada Pav business. More than making money or more than anything else. The first thought came, can it become corporate? Prime stores, we put with this money. Are you all with me? Talia, Talia. Keep yourself awake and everybody awake around you. Promise. Hey, but this is a small bomb. We want a Sivakasi bomb, time bomb, atom bomb. Louder. This was a landmark store. We did 3 or 4 stores and we realized again that the real estate in Mumbai is very, very costly. What is costly? Real estate. 1.5 lakh ka bada, 1 lakh ka bada, 50,000 ka bada. Subiksha was growing, Reliance was growing, Big Bazaar was growing. And nobody was ready to give a store for Vada Pav. Oh, he started asking, are deposit to de dega, bada de paega? Because in Mumbai, the Vada Pav store on the street. So nobody was even ready to give us stores. And said, TK 50,000, give me 10 months deposit. Normally, it's a 10-month deposit. So the 5 saal ka deposit rakhna padega. Kitna? 5 years. And we were finding it difficult to get stores. The rentals was costly. Our investors said, we are giving you up to 1 crore. The remaining money, if you want, you put stores and show us. And they said, we give you 15 days. Otherwise, we will withdraw. Otherwise, we will withdraw. That 15 days became 1 week. It became 3 days. Last 3 days, they told us, otherwise, enough. We cancel the... At this stage, I and my co-founder were desperately moving the footpath of Mumbai. And on the Mumbai footpath, have you seen RA milk centers? The milk booths? 1800, I think you have seen. 1800 of them on the foot milk at one point of time is the only legal milk center or the retailer on the footpath of Mumbai. As entrepreneurs, firse itin 3 days jugaad lagaya and acquired these 1800 booths somehow. And 350 booths were painted with Goli. Hey, this requires celebration. Are you all attentive? Vada Pav got one more retailer on the footpath of Mumbai. 350 plus RA booth on the footpath of Mumbai. And we said, wow. We signed one of those greatest cricketers of our time. We were about to launch the Vada Pav on Gateway of India. And suddenly, this article appeared. How many of you are familiar with this? It's a local Mumbai Maharashtra newspaper run by some politico. This was the second 500 Marathi youth will get employment. And with this, Vada Pav became a politically sensitive issue in Mumbai. What it became? A politically sensitive issue in Mumbai. And we had to withdraw from RA booth. 4 crores of fund raised. 4 crores of fund raised. And in a span of 3 months, this money was gone. And we said we'll raise the second round because it was very difficult for us to handle the political situation in Mumbai. Anything can happen in business, huh? It's a very dynamic world. And you have to be ready as an entrepreneur for anything. We didn't know how did it happen, from where it started. But in just 3 months' time, we were unable to handle the political situation. We thought we'll raise money, but this thing happened. How many of you heard about Lehman Brothers? Lehman Brothers, Satyam, Subiksha and all the investors vanished. We were left with 350 fryers and fridge, no money in the bank, no manpower, and everybody thought Goli was closed. But sometimes some ideas and some stories are great. One store happened in Nasik after we literally closed down in Mumbai. Are you all with me? And from one store, somebody ate a vada pav in Nasik and Aurangabad started. Somebody ate a vada pav in Aurangabad and Jalna started. Nanded, Dulia, Jalgaon, Nagar, Latur, Bid, Parbani. 75 stores in just 15 to 18 months with no money, no manpower, no marketing. The product sold on its own. Sometimes the product has to find a different market. You have to be patient. We thought vada pav will sell in Mumbai. But more than anything, the destiny. We say, whatever God does, He does it for good. We realized if Pizza Hut and Domino's, would they have sold pizza in Italy or outside Italy? Where would they have sold the pizzas? And we realized vada pav has to go where vada pav has been only heard, never sold. And all this store came up, blocks, and this is Goliman. We created, after Superman and Spider-Man, there is Goliman. You don't require money to create this. The Marathi Lagin, Gateway of India and Vada Pav. This is a beautiful innovation that we did. Sounds of Mumbai. We recorded, you know, the Mumbai sound. Platform number 4 ki gaadi, platform number 6 pe aa rahi hai. Krupaya yatriyon se nivedan hai ki platform number 6 pe chale jaiye. How many of you have heard? Platform number 4 ki gaadi, platform number 6 pe. It's a Mumbai local train. We recorded it and started playing in Coimbatore, Bangalore, UP, Lucknow. People were eating vada pav associated with the Mumbai sound. So the brand got built in various form, association with Mumbai. Ganpati Bappa Maurya. We took all this, Satya. But our biggest winner was Ab Goli Ka. You know, there is a famous dialogue in Shole. Have you heard about Shole? And the most famous dialogue in India is what? Ab Goli Ka. We just had to put it. One day it occurred to us. Ab Goli. So wherever we went, we put this form. And today for whatever we did, the dance, the drama, 7 states, 40 cities, 150 plus stores, 5 crores plus unit of vada pav sold. Brand is roughly valued at 100 crores. And at last, a venture capital firm recognized this as a corporate business. And we got something like 21 crores of funding. And the story continues. The media. But the most beautiful thing was, Travel and Leisure magazine wrote something very beautiful about us. And they did a survey across the world of ethnic fast food giant. They came out with Pret from UK, Jollibee from Philippines, Nando's from South America, and from India they said Goli Vada Pav. And this all led to the credibility of the Vada Pav story. I keep on saying, picture abhi baki hai. There's a lot of things to happen now. Thank you. I hope I was on time. Huh? I was on time.
Well, that was again a wonderful story narration by Venkatesh, very inspiring, and I hope you all got to understand entrepreneurship completely from him. So thank you, Venkatesh. Thank you for sharing your success story with us. I guess now we are on for the question and answer session. There are a few mics out there. In case you want to ask any questions. Okay, there's somebody there. Do we have a mic? Please. There are a few mics kept, so you may have to come down or go out, and those who want to ask, there is a mic there. Go ahead, please.
Good evening, sir. What is the difference between the ownership and entrepreneurship?
Sorry, I'm not, it's echoing a lot.
Ownership and entrepreneurship, what is the main difference?
Ownership and entrepreneurship.
Yes.
Ownership is an entitlement, if it is handed out to you. Entrepreneurship is blood, sweat and tears to build it. So ownership doesn't necessarily make people entrepreneurs. Entrepreneurs can be owners. I hope that helps. That was the question. Anything else?
Yeah, I think you answered. Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Yes.
Question for Mr. Venkatesh Goliwada Pao. Similar to your story, we had a story in Tamil Nadu, the Annapurna fast foods. They were trying to mechanize idlis and vadas, and it happened to be a great failure. Have you studied that? Would you be able to give some comment on how Golipadao became successful with mechanization and various other things that Annapurna failed? Do you have any idea?
I had heard about Annapurna story long time back, and I don't know the depth of what exactly happened, whether they got technology to manufacture the idlis or whether the idlis were frozen. But being spent in financial services, I knew wastage and pilferage can kill the business. So from day one, it was very, very clear the technology has to come so that we can avoid wastage and pilferage. So according to me, the key differentiator at the starting stage of the business was the technology. And technology. If you had not got the technology, maybe the route taken would have been totally different.
I think to the best of my knowledge, the reasoning was primarily South Indians prefer fresh, hot from the kitchen. So I think whatever I know, they said half-cooked food to be recooked or reheated in the respective outlets and then sell it off. And that's probably was one of the causes that was uttered. But in Vada Pav also, it is very similar. That's where I am seeing the difference. Because even in Vada Pav, people want it hot, keep it in the pav and eat it. So, how does it make a difference?
See, what we do is that the vadas come from Mumbai in a frozen truck. They are in a frozen chain like ice cream. At the store level, it is fried at 180 degree temperature. So, the product at the tongue temperature is 70-75 degrees. It's fresh and hot. What the Americans say or the French say, frozen is fresh. Frozen is fresh because there is no microbiota, there is no bacteria. It's got the best technology. What most probably Annapurna wouldn't have had because there is no idli making machine in the America or in the Western world. But there is a patty making for burger. So somehow we got a good technology, which is like you make a blade with Gillette technology and you make a blade with local technology, there will be a huge difference. I felt the technology was the differentiator.
Thank you.
Excuse me, sir. Myself, Naushad from SRM University. I have got a question to Venkat sir, Goli Vada Pav. Sir, since you have chosen the Goli Vada Pav, which is very much famous in the north side of Indians, but do you have any idea to take up the items which is very much familiar in the south? In future, do you have any idea of selling the things? Because most of them are sitting here, they may not be knowing about the Goli Vada Pav, like in the deep, because north it's very much famous, as how you can just take it to the south one.
See, what has happened, in Bangalore we went, a lot of people kept on saying, why don't you add idli, parpu vada and all. But somehow, I am bringing a idli from Mumbai and supplying it here. In every road in Chennai, there is a idli available, there is a parpu vada available. So we stuck to our guns, and what is not available is Vada Pav.
Sir, one thing I can tell you. Mumbai is the place where everywhere you will get a Goli Vada Pav. Where you have succeeded there, why can't you do it in south where you get a idli things?
No, that's why I was telling, we don't sell Vada Pavs in Mumbai. We have only 3 or 4 stores. Our real success has come outside Mumbai and Pune. It's come from Bangalore, it's come from Coimbatore, it's come from Hyderabad, it's come from Lucknow, Kanpur, Aurangabad. I felt that we'll make a Parpu Vada, we'll make other types of Vada, Bonda type. And we sell it in Lucknow, UP. So Sagar Ratna sells dosas in Delhi at 150 rupees. Are you with me? So for you to create a brand, and we may sell a North Indian product in South and a South Indian product in North. That's my thought process. We'll definitely do a Parpu Vada, we'll definitely do a Bonda kind of Vada Pav. But it may do very well in the North. That's my thought process.
It's all the best, and we are hoping to get the different dishes from Goli Vada Pav. Like other than...
No, thank you. Thank you very much. Your point is understood. Yeah, we appreciate it.
Sir, I want to ask Mr. Janakiram, how did he manage a VC fund, number one? Number two, I read you met your wife through Bharat Matrimony. Could he tell about both?
I have a request. Before Murugavel answers, there is so much noise that we are not enjoying answering the questions. As much as you are spending the time, all of them, he has flown all the way from Bombay, so I am requesting you to just keep quiet for another 5 minutes, that would help us.
Thank you, Raju. We raised the first round of funding in 2006, we raised 40+ crore. Till 2006, I was thinking why should raise money, because doing a couple of crores of business. Then realized that ecosystem has changed in 2006, lot of PE companies coming to India. So we realized that if we don't raise money, we won't be successful, because the company raises money, obviously money is a critical component of the business. So 2006, raised the money again, a first-time entrepreneur with not having so much of experience in various things, marketing, other things. We sort of blew the money. In 1 year, we spent that 40+ crore. So 2008, we raised another round of funding. Luckily, the valuation really all jumped, because we were able to grow the business. So it was losing money. We raised another 45+ crore. And thankfully, the 2008 has happened. Unintended consequences. That's what my board of directors told me, look, we are left with probably another 10 crore in the bank. You are losing money. If you continue like this, probably another 6 months, you'll be kind of hitting the end of the tunnel. So we realized that, look, they've been asked to kind of control the cost and all those things. They've given certain tasks to finish. It's negotiating, it's not possible. They believe, look, you as an entrepreneur, create the business, you can do it. 6 months, I realized that how successfully, efficiently business can be run without losing on the top line. We're able to control the cost by 1.5 crore. Then I realized that each and everything can be negotiable. So much of the flop which are built during the course of growing the business out of thing. The business became efficient. So that's a turnaround happened. 2008, it's not only become business become strong and efficient. As I talked about, entrepreneur become CEO. In the product, a lot of innovation happened. That's why the online Bharat Matrimony become so many matrimony things, not other thing. Coming back on how I found my life partner, that was a kind of my initial correspondent with my father-in-law, who posted a profile of my wife. So thankfully, horoscope matched. My father-in-law is very particular, though I was not particular. So it doesn't matter, guys. You may be successful making money and all the things. Ensure horoscope matches.
Great one. I know it's been a very long day. Thank you all. And if there are no more questions, I want to thank Venki Rajgopal for giving all of us a great opportunity here to be with you all. And on behalf of all the panel members here, I wish you all the very best and hope to see many more success stories from all of you in the next 5 to 10 years. Thank you very much. Bye.
Thank you, gentlemen, for that very lively and interactive session. May I now invite Ms. Susha John to kindly step forward and present mementos to the chairman and the distinguished speakers. To Mr. Raju Venkatraman, the chairman of the session, thank you, sir, for having accepted our invitation to chair this session. Mr. S. Venkatesh. And to Mr. Murugavel Janakiraman. Thank you, madam. Ladies and gentlemen, with this we come to end of the business session 2. We will commence the next session, the big debate, in just a few moments. Kindly stay back till we set the stage. And for those who are watching this convention online, stay tuned, we'll be right back.